Tom Gray lay on the barroom floor, having drunk so much he could drink no more. He fell asleep with a troubled brain, and dreamt he rode on the hellbound train. The engine with blood was red and damp, and brilliantly lit by a brimstone lamp. An imp for fuel was shoveling bones, and the furnace rang with a thousand groans. The engine was filled with whiskey and beer, and the devil himself was the engineer. The passengers made a motley crew, churchgoers, heathens, Gentile and Jew, rich men in broadcloth and beggars in rags, handsome young women and wizened old hags, red men and brown men, yellow and white, all chained up. 'Twas a horrible sight. As the train rushed on at a terrible pace, sulphurous fumes burned their hands and face. Hotter and hotter the air became, and burned the flesh from each quivering frame. Brighter and brighter the lightning flashed, louder and louder the thunder crashed. Wilder and wilder the country grew, as faster and faster the engine flew. And then in the distance they heard a yell, "Aha!" cries the devil, "we're nearing hell." Oh, how those passengers shrieked with pain, and begged the devil to stop that train. But he smiled and he laughed and he sang with glee, and he capered about at their agony. "My faithful friends, you've done my work, and the devil can never a payday shirk. You've bullied the weak and you've robbed the poor. Your starving brother turned from your door. You've stored up gold where the casket rusts, and given free rein to your fleshly lusts. You've justice, scorn, and corruption sown, and trampled the laws of nature down. You've drunk and rioted, murdered and lied, blasphemed your God in your earthly pride. You've paid full fare, so I'll carry you through. It's only fair you should get your due. Every labourer deserves his hire, so I'll carry you through to my lake of fire, where your flesh shall be waste in the flames that roar. My imps shall torment you for evermore." Then Tom awoke with an agonized cry, all covered in sweat, with his hair standing high. And he prayed and he prayed as never before, to be free from the drink and the devil's power. And his prayer was not in vain, for he never more rode on the hellbound.